Welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how you can easily design and order your very own wedding invitations with hardly any stress and very little cost. Welcome to the Hub of Knowledge. I'm Georgie McGilley from Georgia Beth Photography and this is my channel. This is episode one of DIY Weddings. Today we're going to be using Canva. Canva is a very simple and easy to use graphic design program online. So go ahead to canva.com, create your own account and I'll show you what to do next.
So let's get to it. Canva has thousands of different design options, but for the purposes of this, we're just going to type into the search bar wedding invitations and then select portrait. And as you can see, there are hundreds of different designs. You can go ahead and pick any. I would advise you to have your wedding colours with you so that when you're looking for a design, you can find something that will fit nicely with your theme. But if you can't find anything that you really, really love, don't worry, just click on something that's closer to it because it will take you to the editing screen and where you can edit pretty much anything. You can get rid of things, you can add graphics, you can change the colours, the fonts, anything like that. So I'm just going to scroll through and find one to edit for you guys. So I like this one, so I'm going to click on that and it will take you through to the editing screen. Now there are so many things on this screen that you can do and that you can edit. Straight away when I look at it, obviously these aren't the names that you will want. So I'm going to go straight ahead and change the names here and I can just click on the section and retype. So I'm going to click Rob and then I'm going to do Michaela. And although I really like this font and I think it looks really smart, I'm going to actually change the font for their names. So you just need to go to the top left-hand corner here, click the drop-down box, and there are so many different fonts you can choose from. I'm going to choose Playlist Script, and I'll do the same for Rob's name. Then now I look at these, they look a bit strange because it's all uppercase and this font doesn't look quite right in uppercase. So what I'm going to do is click on the one that I want to change and I can just go up here to this icon and change it from uppercase to lowercase. So I don't have to rewrite it all. It's really handy. And obviously you can do it vice versa. Now that they're lowercase, it looks quite small. So I'm going to just change the size of the font. So up here to the right of where you've just changed the font is a drop down box for the size of the font. So click down and then choose which size you'd like. The same size for Rob's name. And now that Rob's name is a little bit bigger, I'm just going to adjust it. So I just drop and drag, click and drag into place. Okay, I really like this. It says, together with their families, Rob and Michaela joyfully invite you to their weekend wedding affair. So I think I'm actually going to say something like, together with their families, Rob and Michaela would love your presence at their special day or something like that. So I'll just quickly edit that. So again, I just click on that and retype. I'm just going to highlight, I've actually copied the type from somewhere else. So would love the pleasure of your company. I'm going to put on their special day. And I really like that. I'd like the day to fit up in that kind of line as well. So it's only two lines. So I'm going to just drag it slightly and then re-center it. And it's great because it has these little pink lines that help you figure out where it needs to be and how straight it is. So I'm going to go central in line with all those other lines. Right, now I'm going to show you how you can change the colour of different things. So like I said, with the font, you could go up here where it says text colour and you could change the colour. But I quite like the dark grey for the fonts, but I'm going to actually change the colour of these lines. So all I'm going to do is click on them. Here in the left-hand corner is the colour. Click on that and then select a colour. I'm going to go for gold. But if the colour that you want isn't in these sort of swatches, then you can just click new colour and literally any colour under the sun is there. I'm going to just do it quickly for all the other lines. Click and click gold and click gold. There you go. Okay, so now that I'm happy with the font and what it says, and the colours. Obviously, you'd adjust the date and the time and the venue and everything to suit your own wedding. But now I'm happy with what that looks like. I'm going to just play around with the design a little bit. So even though I like the dark grey for all the writing, I don't really like the dark grey for the background. So I'm just going to click on the background. There it's highlighted, and in this left-hand corner, I can change the colour of the background. So I'm going to select a light grey, and I love the way that looks. If you wanted to use a photo for the background, you could come across here onto the left and click photos. And here, there are so many different free, royalty-free photos that you can use. You can use the search box to pop in anything. So I could put in floral. And there you go, there's so many different free photos. The ones with the little crowns on are for premium subscribers, or you could just pay for the image. But to be honest, there's so many different ones that are actually free that you probably don't really need to worry about choosing one that's on the premium package. And if you wanted to use one of these as your background, all you need to do is click and drag it, and you can drag it into the background. So there you go, that would be that photo, but I'm not going to actually use this today. So I'm just going to go up here, this little icon here undoes anything that you're not happy with. So if you change something and you're not happy with the way it looks, just click undo and it goes back to where you were. Okay, so along here on the left hand side, we have so many different options of things that we can play around with. If we click on elements, this is where you can add in other graphics or other shapes. So I'm going to just show you an example here. I don't actually want to add any more graphics to this particular invitation, but if I just type in flower, for example, it will come up with so many different flowers that I could choose from. And if I fancied popping a flower on, I could. So all you need to do is click on the image that you want, and there it is, and you can just move it, and you can literally change the size of it. You can change the direction it's facing. You can, as we've with the other things, you can go up in the left corner and change the color of it, and you can change the transparency, which makes it look a bit more see-through. So I could make it far more transparent and make it really big and just have it in the background. So many different things you can do with it. If you wanted another one, you just click over here which says duplicate, and it just give you another one. And again, you can just turn it around and move it to wherever you'd like. Whatever objects you've got within your invitation, whether it's type or shape, so like these lines, or actual graphics, you can choose where it is position wise. So I can choose to pop it all the way to the back, and obviously it would go right behind this white shape here, which you wouldn't want. But that just shows you how you can really adjust the position of anything. So you can just click for it to go backwards, and it would go behind. So I'm just going to click undo because I don't want those flowers in here. Okay, moving on to the next one in this left-hand column, we've got text. So if you wanted to add any extra text that wasn't there, all you needed to do is click on any of these things. There's some examples with different fonts here, but to be honest, I quite like to edit the text however I want. So I just click on add a subheading. There you go, you can type in whatever you'd like. So you could pop with love, pop up here again, choose the font that you'd like, and then move it to wherever you want it to go. So again, I'm not going to keep this on this invitation, but I'm just showing you as an example that you can literally do just about anything you like. You could delete all the text on here and restart from scratch. It's totally up to you. So here we go. I'm just going to delete it. So I'm going to click this little delete bin icon. So now moving on to here, we can click on the background, and there are many different options for the background. So if I didn't want this sort of gray background here, I could literally just click on any other ones. So there's like that wood one, obviously that's not a free version, that's why there's a watermark on it, but this is free, so I could pop this and it would have the pineapples in the back, or I could select this blue one. Totally up to you. You can choose different backgrounds in that way as well, but I don't like those, so I'm going to go back to the gray. And then here you can upload your own images, which makes it completely fully customizable. So if, for example, you have had an engagement shoot, or you'd like to go and have an engagement shoot, I'm a photographer, so feel free to contact me and get a hold of me, because I'd love to do an engagement shoot for you, and I can help you design your save the dates or your wedding invitations with a photo from one of your engagement shoots on. Really happy to do that. I'm just going to show you how you can do that. So you could choose a picture from your engagement shoot and just drag it into the background. Obviously you can't see this here, so what I would do for this particular photo is either select this white frame that we've got in the background and make the transparency go right down faded so that you can sort of see them faint in the background, or I would choose to click on it, delete it, have them in the background, and then again, because you can't see the type, I would bring the transparency right down so it's just nice and faded in the background. Again, it's totally up to you, design it however you like. I'm going to go back to having the grey and white. Now, most wedding invitations obviously have more information than just the date and time and the venue. So what you need to do is click copy page, and it will give you a second page that is exactly the same, as you can see. And here you can delete the text that you don't want and just play around with it and do whatever you like. So you could put a map for how to get there. You could put your gift list information. You could put example hotels. You could put pretty much anything you fancy, and just go ahead and delete all the bits that you don't want, and you can add anything. So if you wanted to add a little map off Google Maps, obviously if you'd had the image already on your computer, you could click here, upload an image or video, choose to upload this little map, click on it, and it will appear on your design, and you can adjust it, make it smaller, pop it wherever you like. So I'm just going to edit this and then I'll show you what I've done. So here you go, I've edited the second page. I've put a little map, like I showed you, how to get here. I've put some parking information and then gift list information. Obviously, you can put whatever you fancy on the back here. So now what you need to do, once you're happy with the design, you just need to click on the little download icon, choose PDF print. So there's so many different options that you can download it as, but download it as a PDF print, and then you need to download the pages separately. So choose page one, click done, then click download, and do exactly the same for page two. I suggest that you go ahead and save the images on a separate wedding folder on your desktop so you can easily find them if you need to order any more, or if you just want to keep it digitally as a keepsake. At this point, if you're really on a budget, you could choose to print your invites at home. But although you can save a bit of money doing this, it's often an added stress that you don't need when you're wedding planning. So the second site that we're going to use is bananaprint.co.uk. If you're watching this and you're not in the UK, there are plenty of other printing sites, but I've used Banana Print several times now and I can vouch for their quality. So this is why I recommend them. So go ahead to bananaprint.co.uk, navigate to all products, then marketing materials, then postcards. Often when you go to sites that specifically print invites, the price just skyrockets like crazy. So I found that if you order your invites as postcards, it massively cuts the cost and means that the card is perfect quality and thickness to send in the post, and it lasts pretty well without getting all dog-eared on someone's fridge door. So you need to just choose your quantity and how many sides. Obviously we've designed two sides, so we're going to go double-sided. There's a choice between card type. They're both the same thickness, so you can pretty much just choose because they're different kinds of card. And then production speed. So here they are literally for 100 invitations. It is only $19.95 plus postage, so it's a massive bargain, less than 20p an invite. Okay, click get started, choose upload your own design because you've just designed an incredible invitation, and then select file. Go to your wedding folder where you've saved them, choose your first page. So this is why we've downloaded them as separate pages, separate files. First page, and then choose your second page. F- From here on, guys, you know the drill. Click continue and go ahead and order them and get them posted to you, and just enjoy that your invites are being professionally printed and cut for you at a very little cost.
So I actually use banana print for some of my thank you cards for my clients. Here's what they look like. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel. Pop on your notifications so you don't miss out on any more content. And make sure that you pop in the comments below any of your own tips for making your own wedding invitations. I will see you guys next week, always cheering you on.